Well, the Reason Party's Fiona Patten is one of the crossbenchers that has thrown their support behind the legislation. She joins us now. Fiona, what was it that sealed the deal for you?
Look, what sealed the deal for me was way back in March when I really was asked to support an extension to Victoria's state of emergency legislation, and I was very reluctant to do it. And at that time I said, look, I would only support an extension if we went to developing specific legislation to deal with this pandemic and future pandemics.
Fiona, isn't the Chief Health Officer exactly the person you want to be in charge of declaring a pandemic? Are you concerned that this falls now to the Health Minister?
It's interesting because a lot of the people that complained about the state of emergency legislation were concerned that politicians could hide behind the Chief Health Officer and his advice. So what we've got now, which I think works in a much more, I suppose, a much more democratic system, is that the Premier, on the advice of the Chief Health Officer, will declare the pandemic, but then it will be the Health Minister, on advice of the Chief Health Officer, that will then make any orders that are required under that declaration. And at all times, the Chief Health Officer's advice must be published and made available.
Criticism, as I understand it, though, is if, for example, the Premier is stretching the advice of the Chief Health Officer, there's actually nothing anyone can really do about that. Is there any oversight mechanism or anything, not that will advise against it, but that will actually stop a Premier from going further than the advice suggests?
OK, so if we play this out a little bit. So the Premier makes the advice to make a pandemic declaration. The Chief Health Officer says there's no pandemic. So the advice is that there's no pandemic, but the Premier ignores that advice. That advice is published. The Scrutiny of Acts and Regulations Committee in the Parliament then looks at that. That committee would probably have to say we have to disallow this declaration because there is no pandemic, so it's outside the legislation. So if this very fierce Premier was to go against every single piece of advice, I wouldn't even worry about pandemic legislation and I'd just make it up, because obviously that's the type of person that that Premier would be.
Well, not really. I mean, the whole point is that you want the legislation to survive that kind of Premier. Like, you want it to be able to deal with someone who wants to abuse their power. And what I've heard from you there is a lot of recommendations, a lot of declarations, but nothing that's genuinely preventative. Is there something genuinely preventative from this being abused?
I honestly think that scrutiny of the Scrutiny of Acts and Regulations Committee, which does have the power to put a disallowance motion into the House. Now, whether the House would support that disallowance motion is up to the House, but we can put it there. Now,
Fiona, but that means it's political,
right? Chief Health Officer.
That means it's always at every stage of political process, whereas I guess the idea was if you had, for example, a Chief Health Officer who was responsible not for all the orders, but just for declaring the pandemic. Well, no, he's not acting against the law. He has the power to do it. He's acting against the advice, and there is no mechanism, it seems, to stop him from doing, or her, from doing that.
No, he can only do this if there is a pandemic, and the Chief Health Officer has to say there is a pandemic. I take your point, Waleed, that we would require a parliament to oppose the Premier in this case, but a Premier right now could actually do that. And I think it's a fairly wild suggestion that you would have a Premier ignore the Chief Health Officer, act outside the pandemic legislation, refuse to vote for a disallowance motion on a declaration that has been opposed by the Scrutiny of Acts and Regulations Committee. This would be a Premier that had absolutely no regard to the law, and this would be a very dangerous Premier.
Yes, it would. But there are also wild powers that the Premier has in a situation like this. That's why it's so sensitive. Wouldn't the simplest way through it that should be in the hands of a scientific body or the CHO or someone who's not a politician? And then you take care of the whole problem, don't you?
I guess I would argue that that's exactly what we've got, that unless the Chief Health Officer says there's a pandemic, it would be outside the law for a Premier to call a declaration of a pandemic. So we have that in the legislation. We could try and make this better, but it's hard to suggest that we'd try and make a law that protected us from a premier breaking the law.
All right, Fiona, we'll have to leave it there. Hopefully we don't have to be in this situation ever again, but we appreciate your time tonight.
Thank you very much.